Hello everybody, today we are going to discuss about resources and development lesson in class 10th. What is resource and what is the meaning of development? See, we are all human beings, we are living on the earth planet. So in the environment everything is available. So resources means nothing but which can be used to satisfy our needs and provided it is technologically accessible, economically feasible and culturally acceptable can be say as a resource. So human beings are, they are interdependent relationship between that environment, technology, institutions. So we need all these things. That is why human beings are interdependent on nature, they are interdependent on technology and institutions. So the resources, many resources are available. So that resource are divided into many categories. Generally resources are natural resources and human resources. But on the basis of origin, on the basis of accessibility, on the basis of ownership, on the basis of status and development, we divide the resources into many categories. Okay. So that resource, all the resources, some resources have value, some resources have the value because of that is the stock, less stock. Whatever the resource we are utilizing, but all that resources are divided into many categories. First of all, I would like to tell you on the basis of origin, resources are divided into two categories. One is biotic resource and second one is abiotic resource. So you know that very clearly what is biotic. Bio is nothing but life. There is abundant from the biosphere and have the life such as human beings, flora, fauna, any livestock is there on the earth. So biotic resources means which have life, that all comes under the biotic resource. And abiotic means non-living things comes under the abiotic resources, which are have no life, that comes under the non-living, like metals, rocks, these are all comes under the abiotic resource. Next, on the basis of exhaustibility also resources are divided into two categories. One is renewable resource and non-renewable resource on the basis of exhaustibility. So this is the resources which can be renewed or recycled or regenerate, we can call as renewable resource, like solar, wind, water cycle, energy, forest life, these are all comes under the renewable resource. Non-renewable resource are those we cannot regenerate. It takes a long year time, like millions year time, millions of years time to regenerate this resource. So we cannot recycle. So these type of resources we can call that non-renewable resources, such as some examples I will tell you, fossil fuels, and we cannot recycle that fossil fuels, and some metals which are there in the earth that are all non-renewable resources. Next, on the basis of ownership also resources are divided into some categories. On the basis of ownership, one is individual resource, second one is community resource, and third one is national resources, and fourth one is international resources. This is on the basis of ownership. So who are having individual person's property, that comes under the individual resource. So like farmer's land, they are having some land, individual resource. One plot, urban area, plots, house, individual resource. Next one, community resource. Community resource is nothing but which are accessible all one group of community people in that village or town. So some place which are there under the community, so that is called as that resource, we can call that community resources. And then after natural resources, national resource. National resource is nothing but all the resources belonging to the nation. Our country has a legal power to acquire the every individual private or property or public property, or government has a right to get roads, canals, railways constructed, buildings, government buildings, whatever you have, total comes under the national resources. And next, last one is international resources. So international resources, there are international institutions which are regulate some resource, that all comes under the international resources. So on the basis of ownership, there are four types of resources. Next, last one, on the basis of status and development, resources again divide into three categories. One is potential resource, on the basis of status and development. One is potential resource, second one is developed resource, and third one is stock. So potential resource in the sense the resource which are found in particular region, but we have not been utilized that resource. We have not been utilized. For example, Western Ghats in India, Rajasthan, particularly Gujarat, Rajasthan area. In these places, we can plenty of potential energy is available. We can develop the solar energy, wind energy in these places. Okay, but we are not utilizing that resource properly. That is potential energy. Next, developed resources. Already you know that resources which already survived and which are the quality and quantity we have been determined for utilization, that which is called that developed resources. For example, depending on the technology, the level of feasibility on that development resources will available. Next, stock in the sense nothing but the minerals or materials in the environment which have the potential in the for satisfying human needs, that are all in the stock in the earth. For example, water. For example, water is compounded with two gases, hydrogen and oxygen. So hydrogen can be used as a rich source, what you know, for energy. But we do not have advanced technology know how to use that hydrogen, because these are all in the stock. Like this, in the environment, stock is available, but we do not have proper technology and ideas and knowledge for utilizing that resources. So these resources everyone has to conserve. We have to conserve the resources. We have to protect the resources. Because some resources which we are recycling or which we cannot regenerate, we have to use in that proper way. We should utilize in proper way. Next is development. So what is development? Development, it is a very important thing, because every country, every family, every region think that they want to be live better lifestyle. Every country thinks that to increase their standard of living. So here in the resource, mainly in the resources are vital important role to survival for maintaining quality of life. To develop anything, we need resource. So that is why development and resources both are interdependent. These resources playing very important vital role to maintaining our quality of life. We are getting resources free gift from the nature. As a result, human beings use that indiscriminately. Some people are using more resources, some people are using less resources. That is why we are facing lot of problem. Resources should be distributed equal, because that gifted by the nature. So in the development is a continuous process, but that development should be sustained. We need sustainable development. What is sustainable development? So sustainable development is nothing but in the development we should not harm the nature, we should not destroy the nature, we should not pollute the environment. That type of development we need. That is called sustainable development. So nowadays in the world, many of the countries, they are concentrating only on the development, not on sustainable. So if we maintain sustainable development, so we can conserve the resources, and the next generation people, they can utilize the resources which are available. So all the nations in the countries, they have to concentrate in this. In the year of 1992, one international meetings and conferences also conducted in the year of 1992. Nearly 100 nations, countries, people were participated in this meeting in Brazil. The first international Earth Summit was conducted in the Brazil. So in this, all the countries in the world-wise, they promised to protect the environment. So for using the resources, we need planning. Development is a part on the basis of the resources, but utilizing the resources in the planning method. We need proper planning for utilizing the resources. If you use unplanned method, the next generation people, they will not get any resource. That is why resources we should utilize in the proper planning. Planning is very important for utilizing. And then conservation of resources, because all the resources we cannot regenerate. For example, fossil fuels are there. So the petroleum, liquid, crude oil which we are getting from the earth, we cannot regenerate it. It will take some millions of years to reproduce. So that is why we have to conserve that all the resources. In the development, development is very important, but in the development activity, the same time we can utilize that, we can conserve the resources. We need some planning. Based on the planning, we can utilize the all the resources. So conservation of resources are mainly, for example, how can we conserve? Means we should make a plan which are essential, which are not essential. And we should not use excess resources, we should not waste. Based on that, government has to make some plan. Based on that, we can conserve the resources. And we can use the new knowledge and we can utilize the technology by controlling these resources. Then based on the technology, we can utilize the and we can conserve the resources. Right. So this is the total information about the resource.